Hallo und herzlich willkommen zur WDR Jazzline. Wir sind zu Gast bei den 36. Leverkusener Jazztagen. Heute Abend spielt hier der amerikanische Bassist Marcus Miller und er präsentiert sein aktuelles Projekt Aphrodisia. Viel Spaß beim Hören und Gucken.
Leverkusen, what's happening?
Thank you.
We'll be right back. doing? How's everybody feeling? Yes, yes. It's so nice to be back here. Say hello to Alex Hahn on saxophone. Alex Hahn. On the guitar is Adam Agati. Adam plays the guitar. On the trumpet, Mr. Marquise Hill. Marquise Hill. On the drum, say hello to Alex Bailey. Alex Bailey on the drum. Brett Williams on the keyboards. Brett Williams. And this gentleman behind me, he and I played together with Miles Davis a long time ago. His name is Mino Sinelu on the percussion. Thank you very much. Thank you. We have a new CD called Aphrodisia. Aphrodisia, and we just played you song number one from the CD. It's called High Life. And on High Life, we collaborated with some musicians from Senegal and Mali, and they wrote the lyrics, which is why you didn't understand what we were singing. And we don't understand what we're singing. But it's cool. I asked them what it meant. I asked them what it meant, and they said, it means everybody come on downtown. We're gonna have a good time. So that's what we're gonna do, all right? Yes. Okay, so we played your song number one. Guess what we're doing right now? Song number two. This one's called Bees River. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Bees River. Bees River. Adam Agati on the guitar. Adam. On the guitar. Adam Agati. Can we hear one more time also for Marquise Hill on the trumpet? Marquise. And on percussion, you didn't know your triangle could do that, did you? Mino Sinelu on the percussion. Mino. All right. Thank you very much. So I was telling you that we did some collaborating on this album, the Aphrodisia album. It features these fantastic musicians. And also, I decided to follow the voyage of my ancestors by jamming with musicians who come from different stops along their voyage. So we jammed with some musicians from West Africa, like I mentioned, from North Africa. Also, we played with some musicians from Brazil, from the Caribbean, the island of Trinidad. And then finally, we made it home to the U.S. We played with some musicians in the South, like Louisiana. And then we played with some musicians from the big cities, of course, like New York, Chicago, and Detroit. And when I think about Detroit, what do y'all know about Detroit? When I think about Detroit, I think about Motown. You guys know Motown? Okay, so I was thinking I would like to do a Motown song on this album. And I'm trying to figure out which one to do. And I'm trying to think which is the Motown song with the coolest bass line. All right, so first I was thinking. That's nice, but that's not the coolest one. Come on, y'all. It's beautiful, but it's not the coolest one. I was looking for like the coolest, most cold-blooded bass line. You know what cold-blooded means? It means nasty, ugly, dirty, funky, which means very good. Okay, when I was 12 years old, when I started playing the bass, this is one of the first songs I ever learned, and it's still one of my favorites. It's a bass line that goes like this. Wait, all I gotta do is play two notes? That's a sign of a good bass line. Hold on. You remember that one? It's called Papa Was a Rolling Stone. Mino Sinelu, Alex Bailey. Huh. That's right. Okay, Adam's gonna add some funky Detroit wah-wah guitar. Brett's gonna add some piano. Come on, Brett. Okay, we're gonna smooth it out with some jazz horns. Check this out, y'all. Thank you. Papa was a Rolling Stone. Thank you. One more time for Marquise on the trumpet. Come on, y'all. Give it up, Marquise Hill. Thank you. Thank you. So I told you that Mino and I, we played with Miles in his band a long time ago, 19 blah, 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 blah. And when we were in the band, Miles used to play this one song that had such a simple melody. It was like a melody that a mother would sing to her child when she's putting the child to bed, like a little nursery rhyme. And we were always amazed at the magic that Miles could find inside this little simple melody. We're gonna try to see what we can find with this melody for you right now, okay? It has a French name, Jean-Pierre. This is a cool bass line too, right? I like them. Come on, Mino. Thank you. Thank you very much. Jean-Pierre, Alex Bailey on the drums. Alex Bailey. Brett Williams on the keyboards. Give it up for Brett Williams. Alex Hahn on the saxophone. Alex Hahn. And Adam Agati on the guitar. Just everybody. Just give it up for everybody. Come on now. How you feeling? You guys doing okay? All right. All right. I think I did this next song last time I was here in Leverkusen, but I'd like to do it again because this song basically got us started on this musical chapter, this Aphrodisia thing that we're doing. It was about 5 years ago, and we did a concert in Senegal, Africa. And the day before the concert, they invited us to take a 10-minute boat ride off the coast of Senegal to an island called Gorée. And on this island, Gorée, a long time ago, they used to stockpile captive Africans. They would take inventory, they would count to see how many they had. They would check them out for health to make sure they were strong enough to make that eventual voyage on that boat across the Atlantic into slavery. In this slave house, there were three rooms, one for men, for women, and for children. And these slaves were stacked in these rooms, one on top of the other. It was horrible. And also there was a door. And if you looked through the door, all you could see was water, the ocean. And after a while, they would march these captive Africans through that door, and they put them on the boat and send them away to become slaves. So they actually called the door of no return, because once you went through that door, you weren't coming back. So I decided I wanted to write a piece of music to express what I was feeling standing there. I had heard about Gorée, but it's a whole different thing to stand there and really, really feel it. So I was writing the piece of music, and you can imagine the emotions, anger, pain, resentment. But with this song, I decided I didn't want to just make it about anger and pain and resentment. I decided also I wanted to make this song a celebration, y'all, of the ability of human beings to overcome horrible periods of history. I don't know how they did it. These were my ancestors. I have no idea how they found the strength. But what I think is that music played a very important part. These captive Africans, they couldn't read, they couldn't write, but they told their story through music, through the rhythms. And if you listen to all the different styles of music that made their way from this slave experience, you can hear the story. Talking spirituals, field songs, gospel, New Orleans jazz, rock and roll, soul music, funk music, hip hop. It's all a result of this slave experience. So anyway, I want to play this song for you now. It's a song of anger and pain and resentment, but also it's a celebration. The song is called Gorée. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Gore. Hey, can we hear for Alex Hahn on the saxophone? Alex Hahn on the saxophone. And can we hear for Brett Williams on the keyboards? Brett Williams. Thank you very much. Here's a calypso beat for you. been an honor and a pleasure to play for you. Thank you, thank you. One more time for Adam Agati on the guitar, Alex Bailey on the drums, Mino Sinelu on the percussion, y'all. One more time for Brett Williams on the keyboards, Marquise Hill on the trumpet, Alex Hahn on the saxophone, and yours truly, Marcus Miller Leverkusen. Thank you, thank you. We'll see you again really soon. Till the next time, God bless you. Bye-bye. Thank you very much. Thank you. We're gonna do one more, okay? we'll see you again very soon. God bless you. Bye-bye.